Hey guys, it's Annie. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I wanted to share with you guys a little sort of system that I learned way back in college that I've been applying to my YouTube channel since day one that has led to me reaching all kinds of goals and accomplishments with my YouTube channel, such as getting monetized, reaching 100,000 subscribers, making my first $100,000, building my community, and basically every single other milestone and accomplishment that has gotten my channel to where it is today. And these are what you call S.M.A.R.T. goals, better known as SMART goals, which are essentially 5 component goals that you can set for literally any aspect of your life, whether that is your YouTube channel, your business, for work, for school, that basically makes reaching any and all goals in your life so much easier and also happens so much faster. And along with each one of the points I explain in this video, I'm gonna have a little printable down in my description box so that you guys can fill it out for your own SMART goals and make the whole process so much easier. I just find that physically seeing every one of my goals and my plans like laid out and planned out makes them so much easier to execute and make them happen. So starting out with the first of the 5 components of SMART goals, the S stands for specific. So if, for example, a goal you have for your YouTube channel is to be successful, or if you want to gain subscribers, those are both very, very general goals. Kind of like if you were to order a coffee from Starbucks without telling the barista what size coffee, what kind of coffee, what flavor coffee, and then just kind of expected her or him to just make your coffee on the spot. They can't make your coffee order without knowing what it is you are ordering. Just like your goals are a lot harder to accomplish if you don't know what it is specifically you're trying to achieve. So rather than just saying, I want to gain subscribers, back when I was first trying to grow my channel, I started off with goals of gaining 100 subscribers, then 200, then 500, eventually moved up to 1,000, and then 5,000, and so on and so forth, until I eventually reached my goal of 100,000 subscribers. Once you get super, super specific with what goals you want to achieve, it's then much easier to start building a plan step by step of how to achieve them. If I tell the barista at Starbucks that I want a grande strawberry acai refresher, then she knows exactly what ingredients she needs, what machine she needs, and she's then able to make my drink a whole lot faster. And it is the exact same thing with getting super specific about your goals. So if there are any goals you are currently trying to hit with your YouTube channel, step number one is getting super, super specific about what it is you want to accomplish. Then secondly, you want your goals to be measurable. Because if you want to get from point A to point B, from where you were to where you want to end up, you have to be able to track your progress and see whether or not you're getting closer to your goal. So if, for example, your goal is to get monetized on YouTube, the requirements for that are 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of watch time. And both of those things are measurable because those are both things you can track your progress on. Once you get to 100 hours and then 500 hours, once you reach 500 subscribers, then when you get to 1,000, versus if you're setting goals you can't actually track the progress of, they're going to be harder to achieve because you never know whether or not you're getting closer or further away from your goal. So you want all of your goals to be super specific and measurable. Then thirdly, a big one, you want all of your goals to be attainable. I've always been a huge fan of the expression, aim for the moon and if you miss, you land among the stars. There is absolutely nothing wrong with having big ambitions and big goals. We all have them. But in order to make all of your goals attainable, they have to be goals that you can realistically set to achieve in a specific amount of time. So for example, I reached 75K subscribers back in December, and I decided back in the new year that I wanted to have 100K by my birthday on April 29th, and then I ended up actually hitting it on April 1st. Because based on my projection at the time and how fast I was growing every day and every week, that was a goal that seemed attainable and realistically that I could achieve in the amount of time I had set. One of the biggest goals I've had for a very long time is to buy my first home by the time I'm 25, so in about like 3 to 4 years. However, I have come to learn more recently that it would be a whole lot more attainable for me if instead of buying a whole new house for like $500,000, I just pay off the rest of my parents' mortgage, I pay some money to renovate the house, and then I plant my roots here instead of buying a whole new mortgage. So when you are setting goals for your channel, for your business, or any other aspect of your life, you want to make sure these are goals that you can actually achieve in the time span that you set. You'll just end up frustrating yourself to no end and then end up getting super discouraged and quitting before you have time to achieve them. So you want your goals to be specific, measurable, and attainable. So then fourth, when you are setting goals, you want them to be relevant. It it is super, super important that when you are setting goals for any aspect of your life, that they align with your values and your projections and also your long-term objectives. There are some YouTubers out there who have like 9 million subscribers, make like $1 million a year, live in these massive like SoCal mansions, and absolutely no disrespect to them or their lifestyles, but that's just not me. I was born and raised in the suburbia of Montreal, and that is where I want to spend the rest of my life. I just want to be super like financially comfortable. I want to live slow and relaxed. So while some people have goals for their YouTube channels that are much more ambitious and much bigger, that's just not my vibe, and my goals are a lot more aligned with my ambitions and where I see my life down the road. So when you are setting goals, if you want to achieve them and constantly be inspired to achieve them, you want to make sure that every single one of them is relevant to you and aligns with your objectives. And then the last part of the S.M.A.R.T. goals, the T, the most important one for me personally is time-based. I have spent so freaking long setting so many goals for myself, but always visualizing them like there, like down the road, like years down the road, and something I'm not really looking into or thinking about anytime soon. Meanwhile, what am I doing to get myself closer to those goals? Absolutely nothing. So if you want to achieve your goals or take some steps towards achieving your goals, you have to just stop putting them off, stop thinking of them as like future endeavors, things to do at some point down the road. Decide for yourself, when are you going to achieve this thing, and set an end date. Whether that is something you want to achieve next week, next month, in a year, 2 years, 5 years, and start to figure out and plan out what steps are you going to take every single day, every week, every month, every year to actually make those things happen and achieve your goals. Whether we are talking about your goals as a YouTuber, for your business, for school, for work, or any other aspect of your life, once you have a goal that is specific, that is measurable, attainable, that is relevant, and time-based, you will see that every single one of those goals are going to feel so much more achievable, and you'll be so much more inspired and motivated to actually make them happen. So again, if you guys want to check it out, I will have the printable down in my description box. You guys, I use this template every single time I have a new goal or a new plan. The second I filled out the last line, I am so like inspired and pumped up and just ready to make things happen. But that, you guys, that is pretty much it for how to set SMART goals for your YouTube channel or any other aspect of your life. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, found it helpful in some way. As always, thank you guys for watching. I love you all to the moon and back, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!